happy Monday. Welcome to Power Talk. I'm your host, Jean Adrienne, and I am delighted to be with you on this new moon. It actually just turned new moon about 2 hours ago. So what a fantastic time to be alive on planet Earth. So I've got a great show in line for you tonight. And for those of you who are watching on Facebook, if you would like a reading from Catherine Carrigan, please type into the Facebook comments so that we know that you're there, and then Catherine will be able to give you the reading, and the producer is going to be monitoring that. So my guest tonight is Catherine Carrigan. Catherine is a dear friend. She is the author of, I've lost track of how many books, but more than five.
How many? Eight books.
I knew it was more than five. And she's a medical intuitive, and she's probably one of the most talented medical intuitives that I have met in my time in this doing this work. And she's going to be, like I said, supporting you in supporting your body to heal. But I want to talk, I want to find out more about Catherine. And for those of you who are watching or listening later, her website is CatherineCarrigan.com, CatherineCarrigan.com. So it's so great to see you again, Catherine.
Oh, I know. I missed you. Jean used to live in the Atlanta area, so we would see each other more frequently. But
yeah. So, yeah. So now we are miles apart. You're back in Georgia. I'm back in Florida. Here we go. But how did you figure out that you were a medical intuitive?
You know, that's a great question. And sometimes people ask me, well, you know, when was the first time you realized you were intuitive? So here's a great story that maybe you all can relate to. So when I was a little girl, my parents held, my brother had a birthday party. And his birthday was around Easter. So we had an Easter egg hunt. And my parents made my brother and I hide in the house. And we lived in London at the time. So my brother and I hid in the house while my parents hid the Easter eggs. And when the day of the party rolled around, they opened the door to the garden, and I walked right out the door and went straight to the golden egg. And I mean, literally in 30 seconds, it's like, I wanted the golden egg. There it was. And it's mine.
Of course it was.
I mean, it's like the, you know, the chocolate. That's what you're all about. I'm still all about chocolate. Nothing's really changed.
Me too.
Nothing's really changed. And anyway, so my parents just assumed that I had cheated. So I was spanked, right? Mm. It's like, you know, you must have watched. You must have known where it was. I didn't cheat. I just wanted that golden egg. And so people ask me about, you know, when was the earliest time when you knew you were intuitive? And of course, at that time, being a little girl, I wouldn't have put, you know, two and two together. I just knew that I wanted the egg, and I just knew where it was. And that's the gift of claircognizance, which is just knowing, right? And it's a really useful skill. Just I use it for all kinds of things, like what do I wear today? When to go shopping? You know, we think of intuition as a soul gift, which of course it is. But you can use it for everything practical. You know, when to be, who not to date. You know, I can remember seeing a gentleman, remember being at a yoga conference years ago. And I was in this huge room. There were probably 500 people in the room, and seeing this gentleman across the room, I didn't know who he was. I didn't know his name. And inside I heard, you need to have nothing to do with that person. Well, years, probably 20 years went by. And then it turned out that he had gotten into legal trouble. He'd been having sex with his students. He'd been getting his students to pick up his marijuana packages for him. He'd been stealing money from his business. And, you know, we have to learn to listen. You know, whatever you want to call it, it's just about listening.
Oh, sure. I mean, I'm guilty of the same thing. before Christmas, I went to a manifesting event here in Tallahassee, and I was really impressed with the woman who was running the event, and she was going to do a 3-day event in Florida 2 weeks ago. And it was very reasonably priced. And so she said, who wants to sign up? And I was like, oh, me, you know, and I didn't even really think about it. And so I signed up, gave her the money, made my arrangements, found a place to stay, place to board my dog. And starting around the 1st of January, I began to just know I wasn't supposed to go to that thing. And I ignored it because I'd made all these arrangements and it was all going to be easy, peaceful, harmonious. And the noise kept getting louder as the days went on. You're not supposed to go to that thing. You're not supposed to go to that thing. Wednesday morning of last week, I woke up and they were showing me images of massive car wrecks and people getting diseases and all just horrible stuff to get my attention. You're not supposed to go to this thing. And I finally, when they got graphic enough, you know, I was like, okay, I won't go. And I canceled it. And come to find out, the woman that I was going to be staying with, one of my friends from high school, she had broken her leg and she was on crutches. And she called me that morning and she said, you know, I don't know how to tell you this, but I can't get groceries in the house. I can't clean my house. The place is a mess. And then another friend that we were going to meet for dinner on Saturday night, she had other plans. It was all the things, the reasons that I was going had fallen apart. Because I wasn't supposed to go there because I don't sit well in workshops. I'm too fidgety. I have a hard time sitting still for 8 hours a day. And probably this particular workshop, I could have taught it, you know? So I would have really been bored.
Yeah.
So, yeah. You know, yeah.
My two of my most unusual experiences, like what you mentioned, I was in London in 2005 and a colleague had organized 10 clients to come and work with me. And I was supposed to see those people on a Thursday. Well, the day it was quite interesting because I remember being on the train on the Monday before the Thursday. And all of a sudden, I felt this huge wave of incoming negativity. I had no idea what it was. I'm a Reiki master, so I remember drawing the Reiki symbols in my hands and putting my hands up. I literally couldn't stop it. I was like, what is this? I'd never felt anything like it. And then the next day was a Tuesday. I was in a crystal shop. And I remember seeing these crystals. It's like, I need these. I was like, what is this? And then you know how you look up crystals and what they're about. Well, it was aqua aura quartz. Well, when I looked at what they're about, they're supposed to protect you against a psychic attack. Well, anyway, then the Wednesday comes around and I was like, I'm not supposed to go into London. I didn't know why. All I got was that if I went into London, I'd have a hard time coming back. So I called my friend who had organized for 10 people to come and work with me. And I said, I'm so sorry. I can't come tomorrow. So think about how unpopular you are when you when 10 people have reorganized their life. Anyways, canceled it. That Thursday morning, I'm out for a walk. I come back from a walk and terrorists had blown up the subway.
Yeah.
And so I was like, oh, so sometimes when we get these messages, we don't really know why, you know, you don't have to know why, right?
Yeah.
You just have to listen.
Exactly. So how does that work into being able to figure out what's going on in a person's body so that you can help them heal?
That's a great question. Well, you know, I have a system about how I read people. And in my view, you know, there's basically 5 levels of you. There's a physical body. You know what that is.
Mm-hmm.
There's the energy body, which includes your chakras, your acupuncture system, and the breath. There's the emotional body. And, you know, there's a great quote from Sigmund Freud, which I'm probably going to butcher, which is unexpressed emotions never die. They get expressed in uglier ways.
Yeah.
So, yeah. We know that one. And so your emotional body is the largest part of you. And you have to pay attention to your unprocessed and unresolved emotions because they're going to show up in your, they get stored in your organs and they, you know, it's basically what makes you sick. Then there's your mind, which is your thoughts and your belief. And then there's your soul level, which is who you are. So this is your karma. This is what your soul purposes. And so when I do a medical intuitive reading, I read all five levels because it's my experience. If you have dis-ease or illness, it's happening on all five levels. And disease actually begins in your energy field and comes into the physical. And when you want to heal, you've got to push it out through the physical, out through the energy body, out through emotions, out through your mind, and then out through the spiritual level. And you want to get it, move it all the way out. So when I do a medical intuitive reading, I read all five levels, and then I make specific recommendations about what will work to help you get better. So let's say, for example, that you've got high blood pressure. Well, there could be 30 different things that you could do that would help your high blood pressure. But in your case, what are the two or three that are going to be, you know, it's basically critical point analysis that'll help. Sure. So I do, there's basically two things that I do. Number one is I do medical intuitive readings with people all over the world. I don't have to see people or put my hands on them. And then the second thing is I actually do healing work to clear things. What's been really fun for me is in the past year and a half, I've started doing medical intuitive readings with a healing center based in Costa Rica. And people come from all over the world. And before they go to this place in Costa Rica, I basically get a little report. And it's like Joe Blow in Seattle, who has Parkinson's disease. And he's, you know, 53 years old. And, you know, this is how he eats. And I get a written report. Most of the time, I don't even get a photograph of the person. And based on this, I tune into that person. And then I, in turn, spend an hour and a half, and I write a whole report about what's going on and what I feel will help make people better. Now, I come from a medical background. My brother's a doctor. My father's a doctor. My grandfather was a doctor. My great-grandfather was a doctor, and my uncle was a doctor. If you need to go to a doctor, I'll send you one in a heartbeat, and I'll say, you know, I just had someone in my office this morning. It was like, I recommend that you ask your medical doctor to, you know, do a lab test on this particular thing. So, you know, those of us in natural healing, we want to do things as naturally as possible. But we want to look at that big picture. It's all good. A really great affirmation is every hand that touches my body is a healing hand.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Yes. Every hand that touches my body is a healing hand. And, you know, we want to, really benefit from the knowledge and the good intentions of everyone who works with us.
Yeah. You know, and, I think this is really, really good information because I think that one of the ways that I believe that we've gotten pulled off track, each of us in moving forward on our path, is that we have judged some stuff to be not good, you know, and well, the first thing is judgment's against the rules, and we know that, you know, but by doing that, we've actually limited the frame of reference that we can work in, and I truly believe that the body will heal itself if we get our limiting beliefs out of the way and give it a reason to.
Absolutely. I think a real several things. Number one is if you've got disease or illness, you want to be engaged in your own healing process. Mm-hmm. In the past 3 years, I've spoken to three different people all around the world who had different kinds of cancer or tumors. And they basically waited, you know, until the last possible moment because they didn't want to do anything. It's like, well, do I really have to have the operation? Well, it's like, you know, where were you a year ago? You know, where were you, you know, with your emotional healing and your spiritual healing and your nutrition? You know, you want to be involved as much as possible. And part of that is letting go, letting God, and being open to all the wonderful healing methods. We really live in a fabulous time because we have modern medicine and there's a tremendous amount of information about natural healing and ways that we can help ourselves, including in the work of InnerSpeak, like Jean's talking about, working at the deep soul level to look at our programs and, you know, what have we created in our life and why did we create this, right?
Yep. You know, and I'm actually I'm using myself as my own guinea pig, but I'm actually trying to take this a step forward in helping the body to reconstruct itself. You've known me long enough to know that I've been kind of gimpy with a knee that hasn't worked right for a long time. And so 2 years ago, I had an MRI, and there's no cartilage in there. And the word they used for the meniscus was shredded. So in other words, my knee was a hot mess. And so I've found some things actually here in Tallahassee that have really, really helped me a lot, like prolozone therapy has been very helpful and very healing to it. And some Swarupa yoga has been very helpful and very healing for it. But I got really excited when I found a doctor who did stem cell injections, but it didn't feel right. You know, I heard about it and I should have been like on it, like, you know, right there. But I waited, and I just told her, I said, you know, I don't want to be your first one. So, you know, do some of these and let me know how it's working for your patients. And so finally she called me the day after, Christmas, and she said, okay, so I'm ready to do my next round of stem cell injections. Here's the deal. It costs $1,495 for 2 cc's of stem cells. And they have to be air freighted in because they're very fragile. And so we're going to divide the freight up amongst the patients who want to go in this round. I said, fine. She said, I'll call you back. The next week, her office manager called me, and she said that, okay, so you're scheduled for January the 10th to get your injection, and I need your credit card. It's going to be $26.95. And I was like, what? Wait a minute. No, I write everything down. So I look in my book, and sure enough, I had written $14.95, and I didn't invent that. And I said, no, this is what the doctor quoted me. And she said, well, I'm sorry, that's not the price, you know. So I said, well, then, you know what? I'm not interested in your stem cells. And again, it goes back to what you were talking about with listening, because it didn't feel right in the beginning. Now, whether it was because I was going to get bait and switch on the price of it, you know, I don't really know. I mean, I had questions about what are they going to put in my body? Do these things come from cadavers? Do they come from aborted fetuses? You know, a lot of question about where did the material come from? But that question was answered at the point that I got the first quote. So what I realized from that, me personally, is that apparently the universe is pushing me to get outside the box and let my body create new cartilage in my knee.
You know, I'll have to send you, I wrote a very in-depth article about healing the knee. It's called The Ultimate Guide to Healing Your Knees. I'll send it to you.
Please.
Because yeah. It goes into all the different aspects of healing your knees. Mm-hmm. But, you know, you bring up something really important, which I feel is, you know, when we're all human, we have bodies. We're basically a soul with a body. And, you know, whenever we suffer from illness or disease, a really good prayer is to ask to be led to the people, places, and resources who will heal us most efficiently, easily, and graciously, you know, yes, by grace and perfect timing, right?
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, I've basically been using my own version of that prayer now for a while. And, you know, and my knee keeps getting better. I mean, theoretically, I should have had a total knee replacement a year ago. But I just don't want to do that to my body. I don't believe in my communication with my body that that's what my body wants. Yeah. So, you know, so there's that piece of it.
Yeah. I also feel that, you know, illness is a great teacher. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we can say, you know, what's this about? What is it that I'm supposed to learn from this? And, you know, the faster you get the lessons, then, you know, the more quickly you can move through.
Exactly. Yeah. And I've been working on myself. I've had other people work on me with, you know, emotional, mental, and spiritual healing now for a while. I've peeled away so many layers around this whole knee thing that I'm down to the nub, you know, of the stuff. And it's coming really fast now. And, you know, at some point, it's probably my next book, you know, How I Heal My Knee.
How I Heal. Absolutely. Well, my understanding about knees is the emotion behind it. such as it is, it's about moving forward.
Absolutely. And yeah. I've been clearing layers of that and fear around moving forward, fear around standing in my truth and stepping out there.
Absolutely. Yeah. And the, you know, left knee is about, you know, you're at the soul level, and then right knee is about the physical level, right?
It's my right knee. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So again, you know, and it's so funny because some of us will go, oh, that has nothing to do with anything. I remember years ago, I had trouble with my left wrist. I had pain in my wrist. Mm-hmm. Because I have a Bible bump. Well, it was hurting a lot. I found the emotion behind the wrist, and I started taking a flower essence. Well, it was so funny. I started taking the flower essence, and the pain went away. I was like, oh, this is great. I just take this flower essence, and then my wrist doesn't hurt. And then I remember I went through the flower essence. I was like, well, I guess I'm done with that because, you know, the remedy's done. I must be done. So I stopped taking the remedy. Within about 2 days, the pain came back. I was like,
probably came back with a vengeance.
Exactly. I was like, isn't that interesting? So it just took a little bit longer. Mm-hmm. So, you know, so I took a second bottle and, you know, like moved through that. It's like, well, I thought it was done, but there is more layers, right?
Yeah. You're one of the first practitioners to introduce me to how powerful flower remedies really are. Because you did some healing work with me. Goodness gracious. Way back in the day, 2006, something like that, you know, and we worked with flower remedies, some other stuff, and really helped.
Yeah. And, you know, people sometimes ask me, what do I think are the most powerful natural healing remedies? You know, I mean, there's so much great stuff out there. There's supplements, there's homeopathy. I mean, there's, you know, hundreds of techniques, hundreds of things that we can do. In my view, the most powerful natural healing remedies are actually flower essences. Mm-hmm. And if you think of flower essences like colors, right? So for example, blue, you know, I can say blue and you can think of one hue and I can think of something else. So if you find, when you find the specific emotion, and it's, emotions are vibrational patterns in our body. And this again, once you understand, you hold the unresolved emotions in your organs, in your tissues, in your muscles, in your joints. When you find the flower essence, that's the precise vibration that's going to resolve those unprocessed emotions, there you can move through a tremendous amount of things. And, you know, we're very big on, you and I are big on positive thinking and affirmations. But you have to see these emotions are vibrational patterns, mm-hmm. that you may have held for a very long time, could have started at birth or even in multiple past lives. Maybe you've done the same thing, you know, in multiple lives,
right.
And you're used to it. I did a medical intuitive reading about 2 weeks ago with a gentleman who'd had a very severe neuropathy for about 15 years. And he was referred to me by his medical doctor who wanted to understand what is the cause. So again, I read the physical, energetic, emotional, mental, and spiritual. It was, I found that he had Epstein-Barr virus in his brain for about 15 years. So it was really affecting his nervous system. But here's something super interesting. I said to him, I said, your outlook, I said, you're on a mental level, you're always looking for what could go wrong. And I said, this sort of looking for the bad guy around the corner and expectations of basically disaster have filtered down so much into your nervous system that your nervous system is constantly on guard. He said, oh, yes, I used to be a chief financial officer. And I was in risk management. So it's this expecting the black swan, like, you know, sir, it's, right. It's going to all fall apart any day now. It's just a matter of when. So it's so interesting, again, how our thoughts, our expectations, our beliefs, and our outlook your body translates that. And, you know, you don't want to be Pollyanna-ish about it. Yeah, you know, we all have a shadow. Other people have shadows. And, yeah, bad things happen. It's true. It's a fact of life. But when your outlook is finding the peace, and I always say it's going to translate. So I always tell my clients, the angelic is here, the demonic is here. It's just what you focus on.
That's right. You know, in fact, I was having the same conversation with one of my clients that I was coaching yesterday, because I have been noticing the last few times I talked to her that almost every word out of her mouth was something judgmental or negative. And so I said to her, I said, you know, you've got to go on a fast, you know, and that fast has got to be cleaning up your negative thoughts and cleaning up your words, because your words, Florence Scovel Shinn said hundreds of years ago, your word is your wand, and it comes out of your mouth, and you're like, it's like your magic wand creating it, you know? And so, her homework until we talk again is, you know, to be totally conscious of what she's thinking and what she's saying at all times, so that she can begin to shift out of creating this reality that is gloom and doom.
Yeah. You know, it's so funny because years ago, a friend of mine told me about this positive thinking class. And I thought, well, everybody knows you should think positively. Why should I go to that class? But I kind of tuned in. It was like, oh, no, you need to go to that class. Well, this is when I was in my early 30s, and I'll be 60 in March. So this is like, you know, whatever, a long time ago. And anyway, the very next day after I heard about the positive thinking class, I got diagnosed with chronic fatigue syndrome. And I thought, that's why I need to go to this positive thinking class. So I would sit there and go, I am radiantly healthy. Point my nose. I am radiantly healthy. Well, now I am radiantly healthy. Yeah. Right?
So yeah, you're one of the healthiest people I know.
Exactly. But I used to not be.
Right.
You know? Exactly. So, yeah. So, you know, you can start to take, no matter what your external circumstances, you can start to take ownership and create the health and the life that you want by visioning it, by speaking it in, and by feeling it into reality. What's it going to feel like when you're radiantly healthy? Mm-hmm.
Well, this has been so much fun, Catherine. It's great seeing you again. And we've run out of time, but listeners and viewers, so her website is CatherineCarrigan.com, and you can find out about her books there. They're available on her website, on Amazon as well. They're amazing. And also, you can schedule a reading with her, and she can work with you wherever you are in the world, and you'll benefit, I promise you, from that greatly. So thank you, Catherine.
Thanks so much for listening.
Yeah. And so next week, viewers, my guest is going to be Dr. Kenneth Pelletier, and we're going to talk about DNA. He's got a new book out called Change Your DNA, Change Your Life. So I know you're going to enjoy that one. And if you haven't been to my website already, it's jeanadrienne.com. Go there and you can sign up for my newsletter, and I will send you a link to the online version of my InnerSpeak cards. It's a game, basically, that enables you to do the same thing you would be doing with the cards, to clear for yourself privacy of your home on your own computer. So until next week, remember, people who take responsibility for their lives create the reality they desire. Ciao.